You know, I kind of feel bad. I actually dragged RJ to see this next film, and judging from the title, I should have known better.
Yeah, no shit, boss.
Oh yeah? The Fifth Wave.
Fair enough.
That's what I thought.
Right here.
Hi, Faceless here, and apparently Hollywood has punished me for whatever reason.
God damn it, f*** Hollywood and f*** everything that it's done.
For shame, Hollywood.
Stop splitting up the damn novels.
It stands for, it doesn't even know how what to do with itself, but the f*** is-
No, 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 God no. You had a good story to begin with. What the f*** are you doing? God damn it, Hollywood.
Come on, Hollywood.
Okay, fair enough. Pride and Prejudice and Zombies. Based on a novel by... Wait, this was actually a novel?
This ain't really surprising, boss.
You know what? It doesn't. Anyway, based on a novel by Seth Graham Smith, the story is a mashup of zombies and the original Pride and Prejudice novel by Jane Austen. And aside from the addition of zombies in this alternate universe, the plot is basically the same as the original Pride and Prejudice. We do, in the beginning, get a little background of what caused the outbreak, taking the Black Plague to a whole new level. However, much like the original, the story focuses on Elizabeth Bennet and Mr. Darcy on their on and off attraction. Other than the zombies being added to this classic story, Elizabeth and her sisters were not only raised to be proper women of the time, but they were also trained in the art of killing zombies. And for the most part, that's pretty much the plot. Look folks, I'm gonna level with you. If you've read the original or seen any adaptation to Pride and Prejudice, you're really not missing much. Sure, you got the zombies and the fight scenes with them were pretty damn awesome, but I'm gonna be honest, they felt chewed in. And the fights themselves were so far in between that it was kind of a drag to watch. The first few minutes of the film got me interested and I was like, yeah, I'll go with it. But then it slowed down to the same damn plot to the original story. Now, there was this one subplot that, if they stayed focused with it, the story would have been a hell of a lot more interesting. But it really didn't go anywhere, and it's sad because I was really invested in that part of the plot line. I mean, zombies with a hierarchy? God damn it, build up on that! The actors they had for this film were... okay, I mean, they were adequate. Except for the guy that played as Mr. Darcy. I don't know what it is about him, but I just didn't like him. He just didn't seem like he fit the role. And what's with the voice? I mean, did you really have to sound like Batman? And it was kind of cool to see Matt Smith's character. Like I said, I'm a Whovian. I really don't have much to say about this film. Honestly, I feel like I was duped in watching a poorly made version of Pride and Prejudice. And with that being said, this film earns a D rating. And you know what, I actually read the reviews on the novel itself, and I heard that it was really good. The zombie one, not the original one. I mean, seriously, what are you guys doing over there? I mean, you've taken four novels already this year, already four novels, and adapted them to movies, and they've done poorly. What the hell? You know what, I'm not gonna go in this little tirade. I don't know what they're doing over there, taking, you know, halfway decent novels and then just making crap for films. I just don't get it. Well, this wraps up this episode. If you have any thoughts or opinions, please leave a comment below. As always, you can watch my previous videos on peanutbutterdisaster.com, where there are other producers and their content, so check them out. And if you hadn't done so yet, hit the subscribe button below for more upcoming reviews. Of course, the next movie I'm going to watch is going to be based on another novel, so let's go see how bad they screwed this one up. But until then, this is Faceless, signing off.
Peanut butter disaster.